Update now on the shark attack off Lovers Point in Pacific Grove. State wildlife experts now say the adult great white shark was 14 to 15 feet long. They examined the victim's wetsuit and talked to witnesses in order to make that determination. 62-year-old Steve Broomer barely survived the attack. That's according to his doctor. His doctor said that the shark came within a millimeter of severing a major artery. All of this comes as the Monterey Bay Aquarium is reporting an increase in great white shark sightings. Action News 8 reporter Christian Balderas is live in Monterey on what it means for public safety. Christian?
Hey, Aaron. The Monterey Bay Aquarium recently unveiled a new study confirming that we're seeing an increase in great white sharks along the California coast, more specifically, a new population in Northern California. Now, that is of concern because of the possibility, though rare, of a great white shark attack like the one we saw here in June in Pacific Grove off the coast of Lovers Point, the first one in over decades. The Monterey Bay Aquarium once housed one of the most ferocious animals in the ocean, the great white shark. But in 2006, the aquarium phased out the exhibit due to dwindling populations. Now, new studies say they've rebounded.
The number of sharks people are seeing does appear to be increasing, and that's consistent with what appears to be an increase in the number of juvenile white sharks.
Researchers and the public on high alert after multiple dangerous shark encounters off the coast of the Monterey Bay.
Most often we think that when a white shark bites a person, it's a mistake. They either think the person is a seal or a sea lion, or sometimes in the case of smaller sharks, they really do explore their world a bit and they tend to bite all kinds of objects.
And it's the juvenile white sharks who have gravitated to warm waters that are on the move. After over 20 years of researching sharks in Southern California, the aquarium found they're moving north.
But we had a heat wave, what they call it, a blob of warm water that lasted for several years. And then this heating of the surface waters actually seems to have opened up a swim corridor from what was Santa Barbara, which used to be their northern range, all the way up here now. They're able to come up through Aptos.
This warm corridor is closer to shore, hence more sightings and possible attacks.
This is one of the aquarium's first example of how a marine animal has demonstrated the effects of climate change. And it comes with some detrimental effects.
In Monterey Bay, a threat to the local sea otter population, which could tip the fragile ecosystem in the Monterey Bay. Now, the aquarium says that they were out on the water near Aptos last month, and they saw a surprising number of sharks, and they say that is concerning because this isn't their peak season. Peak season is in August. Now, whether this is because of a general and overall increase in great white shark populations or, again, that migration from southern to northern California, they don't know. But what they do know is that this new population here in the Monterey Bay is due to climate change. Reporting live in Pacific Grove, I'm Christian Balderas, KCBW Action News 8.
All right, Christian, thank you.